Hey guys, William Irizarry here, one Yoruba like Warirote. Today we're going to discuss Orisha Obatala, spelled O-B-A-T-A-L-A. Obatala translates to King of the White Cloth. Alternatively, King of the Undyed Canvas or Blank Canvas. Obatala is a major Orisha within the Yoruba pantheon and is considered in most cases one of the oldest Orisha and father to most. Obatala is considered an Orisha Funfun, which translates to white or pure. Obatala is central to the creation myth of our tradition, which I will elaborate on in another video. Okay, Obatala is responsible for creating the first human figure to which Olodumare animated by breathing life into. Obatala is also responsible for molding every child in the womb. Obatala represents all that is pure and white in this world. He represents morality, peace, honesty, forgiveness, and patience, as well as knowledge and wisdom. Obatala is also known as the owner of all heads. Our heads are protected and belong to Obatala until our guardian Orisha is marked properly. We are all born with a predetermined destiny and guardian Orisha. However, until we seek them out via proper divination, Obatala is the guardian Orisha of all humanity. The guardian Orisha will be discussed in another video. Okay? Obatala has many manifestations, from the young warrior to the old wise man. Obatala's colors are white. His eleke, his beads, are all white. And depending on the path or manifestation, may contain hints of red, green, and other corresponding colors. Obatala's number is 8, and he enjoys white foods, such as, but not limited to, white rice, white yam, white echo, white hens, snails, white melon, etc. I hope you enjoyed this little bit of information about Orisha Obatala. If you have any comments or questions, please don't hesitate. As always, please like, share, and follow. More to come. William Irizarry here, one Yorumela, Iborirote, Iboru, Iboya, Ibochiche.